Imagine being able to describe the unseen world inside the womb over 1400 years ago. Before modern science, before ultrasounds, before anyone could even imagine what happens after conception. Yet in the 7th century, a book appeared with an astonishingly accurate account of embryonic development. Could it be mere chance, or does it point to something beyond human knowledge? In this video, we'll uncover the mind-blowing descriptions found in the Quran about how life develops inside the womb. But there's more. We'll use AI to calculate the exact probability that someone in the 7th century could have written such detailed observations without modern technology. You won't want to miss this. Today, we live in a time when science has unlocked some of the deepest mysteries of life. We've mapped the human genome, observed the tiniest particles, and we can now see every stage of life inside the womb. But let's rewind to the 7th century, a time when the womb was a black box. No tools, no ultrasounds, no scientific understanding. And yet, the Quran contains verses that describe the stages of human development in a way that aligns with what we know today. How is that possible? Let's start with the first stage. We created man from a drop of fluid. Surah 23:12. In the 7th century, people had no knowledge of sperm, conception, or how life begins. Yet the Quran makes this precise statement about a drop of fluid being the origin of life. What's fascinating is that today, we know this to be true. Modern embryology confirms that life begins with a single drop of seminal fluid. Could someone back then have known this by chance? The Quran then continues, "We made the drop into a clot, and we made the clot into a lump of flesh, and we made from it bones, and we covered the bones with flesh." Surah 23:14. This is where things get even more interesting. Modern embryology tells us that bones do, in fact, form first before being covered by flesh. This sequence wasn't fully understood until recent centuries, yet the Quran accurately describes this development process 1,400 years ago. Now take a moment and think about this. If you lived in the 7th century, with no access to microscopes or advanced medical tools, would it be possible to describe such detailed stages of development? Could it be that these descriptions were purely intuitive? Or is there a deeper explanation? Even today, with all our advanced knowledge, could any of us simply guess the structure and function of something as complex as the brain of an ant without tools? For the people of the 7th century, the womb was a total black box. They had no way of observing what happened inside, just as we can't observe many microscopic functions with the naked eye today. So, how did they get it right? Let's fast forward to the present day. Thanks to modern tools like ultrasounds and MRIs, we've been able to observe life as it forms inside the womb. We now know, with scientific certainty, that these stages described in the Quran are accurate. The question is, how could this knowledge have existed over 1,400 years ago? But we didn't stop there. We decided to use AI and ChatGPT to calculate the exact probability that a person from the 7th century could have guessed these detailed stages of embryonic development purely by chance. Let's break it down. First, the probability of accurately describing even one stage of embryonic development by chance is incredibly low, 1 in 10 billion, or 10 to the power of minus 10. Now, when you add in multiple stages, the probability becomes astronomically smaller. The chance of accurately describing each stage, one after the other, without scientific tools, it's effectively zero. AI calculated that the chance of someone in the 7th century accurately describing these stages of development is, well, 100% impossible for a human. This leaves us with one conclusion. This knowledge had to come from a source beyond human capability. The Quran's accuracy in describing these stages is no longer up for debate. Whether it's the creation from a drop of fluid, the formation of bones, or the covering of flesh, the Quran aligns with modern science in a way that seems beyond the scope of human knowledge at the time. So, what do we make of this? Is it coincidence? Could it be intuition? Or is it, as the Quran claims, divine knowledge? Based on the AI's findings, the answer is clear. According to AI's calculations, it's 100% impossible for a human being, living in the 7th century, to have written these descriptions based on guesswork or intuition. The precision is simply too high, and the chance of getting it right is essentially zero. What remains, then, is the overwhelming likelihood of divine knowledge. And if you've been moved by this video, please reflect. And don't just keep it to yourself. Subscribe, like, and share to be part of spreading this incredible knowledge.